What happens when a zombie virus infects the entire country overnight? A group of survivors have to form a team to face thousands of zombies and survive. Stick around till the end. The movie starts in a hospital, where a doctor is inquiring a nurse named Anna about a patient who was bitten by someone. Anna goes to the reception and finds out that he's taken to the ICU. Anna is surprised that biting someone can be that dangerous. She comes home from work and has an intense sexual encounter with her husband. The next morning, her husband wakes up to the sound of the door opening. Just then, he sees his daughter, but as she steps forward, her torn face is revealed. The man quickly goes to check on his daughter and tells Anna to call 911. Suddenly, his daughter attacks him, biting the man on the neck. After seeing this, Anna quickly pushed her daughter away while the man fell on the bed. Her daughter was looking different, and she charges at Anna in a creepy fashion. Anna immediately locks the door. Anna tries to save him by stopping the bleeding, but nothing works, and he goes unconscious. She calls 911, and suddenly, the man stands up like nothing happened. He turns around and charges at Anna like an animal. He's completely turned into a zombie. She quickly grabs the car keys and somehow manages to safely get into the bathroom. She tries to open the window, but it won't budge. Suddenly, everything goes quiet, and she slowly walks next to the door and calls her husband's name. The zombie breaks through the door with his head, and Anna somehow manages to jump out of the window of the bathroom. She unlocks her car and asks her neighbor for help, but instead, the neighbor aims a gun at her. Suddenly, a speeding ambulance crashes into him. She is shocked to witness the chaos in her neighborhood. Just then, Anna's husband comes outside, but Anna instantly jumps in her car and locks the car door. However, his husband manages to do some damage to the windshield. The zombie virus has spread throughout the entire city. Zombies are biting everything they see and cars are crashing into each other. Then Anna pulled over to take a break. A big man opened the door and tried to steal her car. Anna pushes the accelerator and successfully escapes the big man. However, she doesn't get far and crashes straight into a tree. Moments later, she regains consciousness and gets out of the car. Just then, a police officer named Kenneth points a shotgun to her head. He asks her a question and puts down his gun when he sees that she's not a zombie. They then decide to help each other and survive the zombie apocalypse. Later, they went under a bridge and ran into another group of survivors, who instantly fired at them. But later, they apologize for mistaking them for zombies. The survivors consist of Michael, Andre, and his wife. The cop wants to go to Fort Pastor because his brother is stuck there. But they advised him not to go there, as they also tried but lost 5 of the group members. They form a team with the survivors and decide to go to a mall to get some supplies. However, the entire mall was locked, so they decided to enter from the backside. As they were trying to open the door, 2 zombies emerged out of nowhere. They charged straight at them. Kenneth shoots the door lock, and Andre shoots to cover him. After getting inside the mall, they quickly shut the door closed. They then tried to call for help, but there was no signal. They split up into groups and had to make sure that all the doors were locked. Michael hears a noise coming from a shop. He opens the door and sees a zombie feeding on someone. The zombie aggressively jumps on him, while Michael shouts for help, alerting everyone else. Just then, another zombie pounces on the pregnant woman. Kenneth didn't want to hurt the woman, so he hits the zombie with the butt of his shotgun. The zombie attacks him, and they both go into the pool. Anna quickly picks up the shotgun and eliminates the zombie, saving Kenneth's life. Meanwhile, Michael also manages to kill the zombie. Michael then joins the group, and they go straight to the elevator to go to the first floor. But when the elevator door opens, there are already 3 security guards waiting for them. CJ is the senior of the other guards. CJ tells them to go back to the ground floor, but it's not safe to go back, so they eventually let them in. However, they take all of their weapons from them. After that, Anna treats Kenneth's wounds, while Andre finds out that his wife is infected, but he wants to protect the baby, so he decides to hide it from the rest of the group. Guards hear on the news that things are out of control, and the virus has spread across the entire United States. They also learn that the virus can only spread through a bite or a scratch. You can only kill them by shooting them in the head. The guards then went to the ground floor and found a zombie in the pool. They confirm that they indeed die from a headshot. Meanwhile, the rest of the group makes a big help sign on the rooftop of the building. They spot a survivor on the top of a building in front of the mall. At night, CJ locks them in a compartment so they don't do anything wrong. The next day, a guard goes to the security room to check the CCTV cameras. Just then, he sees a delivery truck speeding towards the mall. Everyone wants to save the survivors in the truck. CJ doesn't want to take any risks. But the other guard also wants to save them, so CJ points the gun at him. Suddenly, Kenneth and the others take their guns and lock them inside. Then they signal the truck to come from the back door. Michael and Andre come out and start shooting the zombies so they don't come close. While a couple is already on the top of the truck, who reveals that 6 more people are in the truck. Just then, more zombies show up and Michael closes the door. Luckily, they save all the survivors. Now that they have a truck, Kenneth wants to go to Fort Pastor to save his brother, but a survivor reveals that place is destroyed. But Kenneth doesn't care. Michael stops him by saying that they need him here. On the other hand, one of the survivors got sick and died. Moments later, the woman wakes up and charges at Anna. But Anna somehow kills her with a metal rod. Anna then tells Andre and Michael about the virus and the infected woman, explaining that it spreads by bite or scratch. This is when Andre realizes the gravity of the situation. Nicole's dad is also infected, so Michael prepares to kill him before he hurts someone. Nicole doesn't want him to die, but her dad consoles her. Just as he was about to transform, Kenneth shoots him. Now things are starting to get better, and they are enjoying their time in the mall. Andre has prohibited everyone from seeing his wife. One day, they were all having dinner when suddenly, the mall's power cut off and the generator was in the parking lot. CJ, Kenneth, and Michael carefully entered the parking lot. They felt someone's presence and a cute dog appeared. Suddenly, a zombie pounces on a security guard and bites him. This attracts even more zombies, and they have to run for their lives. They go straight to the generator and lock the iron fence to keep the zombies out. Michael throws gasoline on the zombies and sets them on fire. They watch as the zombies are burned to death. Meanwhile, Andre's zombie wife is about to give birth, and he has tied her to the bed. She gets extremely aggressive, but Andre somehow manages to work it out. Just then, a survivor enters the room and instantly shoots Andre's zombie wife. Seeing this, Andre shoots the old woman, and she shoots him back. All 3 of them died on the spot. Everyone rushed to the room after the gunshots and witnessed the terrible scene. They saw a baby in Andre's arms. Anna picked up the baby, but it turned out to be a zombie baby. They have to eliminate the baby too. The group realized that this place was no longer safe. Then Michael tells them that he saw 2 trucks in the basement that can be used to escape from here. Then they will take a boat to go to a nearby island. In the following days, they made the preparations and modified the trucks to survive the zombies. Kenneth informs the survivor on the roof that only 5 days are left, but he replies that he's hungry and cannot wait. So the group ties some food and a walkie-talkie to a dog to send it to the survivor. The dog went straight into the gun shop, but zombies also managed to get in. The group hears on the walkie-talkie that the man has been infected. Just then, they saw that Nicole drove the truck to the gun shop to save the dog. She was able to get inside the shop. The group then saw the survivor, who is about to turn into a zombie. After that, they decide to rescue Nicole. They reached outside the shop through the sewers, but it attracted the zombies. After shooting a bunch of zombies, they finally entered the gun shop. Inside, they saw the same survivor now transformed into a zombie. Kenneth says sorry and shoots him. They then replenish themselves with more guns and ammo. After saving Nicole, they thought of a brilliant idea in order to escape. They threw a gas cylinder and CJ fired it to cause a huge explosion. They then go through the sewers, but CJ is left behind. The zombies follow him into the sewers. They quickly rushed back to the door, but it was locked. Many zombies are coming towards them. Just then, Anna opens the door, and they run towards the parking lot and quickly board the modified trucks. However, they drove through the steel door, but thousands of zombies surrounded the trucks. No matter how hard they try, the trucks don't move at all. If this continues, the whole truck will flip over. Steve quickly grabbed a chainsaw and started eliminating zombies through the window. CJ gets out and throws a gas cylinder and shoots it to cause a huge explosion again. They quickly took advantage and drove out of that place. Moments later, Kenneth realizes that a zombie is still hanging on the truck. A survivor starts the chainsaw to kill the zombie. However, Kenneth makes a quick turn, which causes the old man to cut a female survivor, and they both die on the spot. The truck also lost control and flipped over. Steve gets out of the truck and suddenly, a zombie jumps on him. When the others arrived, only Kenneth was alive. When they try to get in the other truck, the zombie Steve shows up and Anna shoots him. The gunshots attract more zombies and they run towards them. Everyone ran into the car except Anna, who returned to take out the keys from Steve's pocket. She then runs towards the truck while Michael pulls her in and CJ closes the door just in time. The truck kept moving forward. While the zombies were still behind them, they finally reached the pier. Everyone quickly gets out of the truck and rushed to the boat. However, CJ decides to give cover and attracts all the zombies.
Fucking thing!
He then shoots the barrel of gasoline and triggers a massive explosion, killing all the zombies. Now everyone has boarded the boat, but Michael doesn't want to go with them because he was also infected by one of the zombies. Everyone says goodbye and leaves, while Michael stands there watching them. Eventually, he shoots himself and the movie ends. Subscribe to watch more movie recaps like this. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Goodbye.